Every history book which you read is a challenge of archival power. Because historians can only function with the archive that is available. And then, whenever you are reading history, you want to find out the origin of the archive. On whose interest was the archive? Zero. And if you suspect that this archive is incomplete, where can we probably find it? This part of archive explains why, I do not know if the history department of this university investigates this matter, it explains why one of the greatest scandals of Western historiography is the erasure of Haiti and the Haitian War of Independence from Western historiography. The Haitian War of Independence was the most radical political revolution in the age of revolution. And when you read a historian like Hobbes, perhaps one of the greatest British historians of his time, Hobbes' magisterial work, The Age of Revolution, 1789 to 1843, there are three references to Haiti and Toussaint. And one of the three is Toussaint. Hobsbawm is not only the leading historian of the period in which he's dealing there, but regrettably, Hobsbawm is also the Marxist historian. So this omission cannot even be assigned to conservative fraudulence. And if you get a chance to look at the Penguin Dictionary of Modern History, beginning at much the same time and coming down into the 40s, there is perhaps one mention of Haiti and the Haitian. And yet Hobsbawm would say in his same book that Louverture was the first great liberator in the Americas. But not a page on the Haitian War of Independence. This is an example of archival power. I tell you at a particular time what I think it is convenient for me that you should know. And I want to not only ask, but challenge the University of West Indies to think about the question of archival power and where they themselves are located in dealing with the dynamics of that power. To what extent may the university be the casualties of another